video, I wanted to show you guys something really cool. I got a wireless kit for the HTC Vive that makes it completely, well, not completely free of cables, there's still some cables, but now it's not hooked up to my computer directly. It's a mobile system and there's no cables running across the floor anymore, and I'm able to walk around my office as much as I want. I've seen these things advertised, and they only came out for a certain few individuals a while ago, but now they're up for everyone to be able to buy because they're a proof of concept that's been shown to work. So I wanted to show it off a small bit before I start recording anything, because then this thing has a battery and I don't want it to run out and I don't want to run into issues, so I'll show you. This is it here. So it's not, well, if you have a HTC Vive, it's a lot different, but not really at the same time. It's a bit weird. So now, this is the whole thing on its own. There's no more cables running over to my computer over there. Look at all those other cables over there. Get these controllers out of the way for a sec. So it's just this thing. So the cables from the headset go into this, which is a receiver thing, and then everything goes out and into this, and this is the power. But the way the power works is that it just uses one of these. This is an anchor, or anchor, or however you pronounce it. It's just a regular power bank that you bring around for like your phones and stuff, and you just push that into these. It has two USB slots in the top. I don't know if you can see that. That just slots in, and then the power starts going. So I don't want to plug it in right now because I'm not using it, and I don't want the power to drain, because this thing only has a power of like 2 hours apparently. So you put this in your pocket, or you strap it somewhere, or you find out some sort of solution for it. I'm just gonna put it in my pocket, and then you can walk around as much as you want. So now, we just pick up the headset. There's no cables running out the back anymore. It's all self-contained, and I can walk anywhere around my room, and there's no problems. I mean, my room was not big enough to be able to run out of cable anyway. I was still able to reach everywhere in my room with the cable, but it's nice to not have to trip over it. I don't have to keep the cable out of the way anymore. The amount of times I play HTC Vive games and I've always been like, ah, God, and falling over stuff. So now, not only do I have the deluxe strap, so it has the headphones attached to it, but now I have a wireless kit for it, which means I'm completely self-contained. So I don't have to worry about anything tripping me up anymore. And that, to me, for VR, is insane. I can't believe that that's a thing that can happen. And I'm probably going to try out GORN, because I want to try out a game that I know and a game that I've played a lot, and I just kind of want to play more GORN anyway. But there's some other stuff that this thing came with. It's not just that. It came with this thing as well. TPCast is the company that makes it. And this is just like a little box that I have on a tripod right now. And you just set that up and you run all the power cables and the HDMI into it. There's only two cables going into it that normally go into the little box that your HTC Vive comes with. So that thing broadcasts to the receiver on top of the headset, and that's what communicates with each other. Now, what I'm really excited about for this is latency. Because the wireless solution, it's not that revolutionary. Like, the mechanics and the pieces that are in it are not crazy. But it's the latency that's going to be the big thing. Because that's why you have to do wired VR, because otherwise there's just going to be a lot of lag, and your hands won't move one-to-one with you. That's the big issue with virtual reality, is resolution and frame rate. And if you can master those two, then it's fine. But if the frame rate goes out, then you start feeling sick because you're not moving with the character anymore. And if the resolution is bad, then you're kind of blurry and can't see anything. So I'm really excited to see how this is going to work. And I know a lot of people out there are really excited about this as well. I've had a lot of people tweeted at me to talk about it. It also comes with a little Wi-Fi router. It comes with one of these, which just looks like a regular old router that you have in your house. And then my Ethernet cable that's normally connected to my computer goes into this, and then the cable goes from this out to my computer. So I think that this is handling a lot of the processing and a lot of the bandwidth and everything that needs to happen. And then some signals get sent to this box, and then that sends it to the headset. So it sounds like there should be a lot of lag going on, but I'm not sure. So let's get in. I've played a lot of Vive games. I've played a lot of VR games, so I should be able to detect when something feels off. I should be able to know when something's not the way it's supposed to be, so I'm excited. Let's test it out. I'm in! And it fucking works! Oh my God, that's so bizarre! It feels the exact same. Oh God, I keep thinking this. It feels the exact same! If there's any lag in this whatsoever, it's so minuscule that I can't feel it. Like, it's not making me sick or anything. Look, I can walk around everywhere now! Oh my God, that's the coolest! Two little problems that I ran into was that you still have this big, long-ass cable going down the back. So what I did was I ran the battery pack down the back of my shirt, so now it's all self-contained. So I realized when I was doing this, the cable was, like, flying all over the place. So if you do get this, you might have some way of like strapping all of this shit down. And also, the battery's kind of heavy. So I saw some pictures of it before where it was strapped to the back of the headset, but that would be a nightmare because it would weigh on your head so much and you don't want any weight on your face at all. Putting it in here is fine, but I feel like if you had some sort of like fanny pack or something, you'd be able to put it in a bit better. But anyway, enough talking. Let's actually get in and play the game. Oh, I'm so excited for this. Hi, guys. Salute me and fight, peasant. Oh, the game's been updated. Textures are different. Everything's different. You really know what I'm saying? I can't remember. A lot of this stuff looks very different. Okay, I'll put you on. What else am I using? Do I want to use my spear? Okay, I mean, we're not here to do anything different. We're just here to have fun and kick some ass wirelessly. Let's go, bitches! Who wants to fight some Jack? Who wants to fight some Jack? Anybody want to see some blood? Oh, God. Archer. I didn't realize. Okay. Oh, yes, I got him in the air. Oh, I want to kill someone with this. Yeah, I've never done that. Nice. Okay. Oh, man. Okay, you're going to have to die the normal way. Is that okay? Sorry. Okay. Nice. Okay.
Fucking
Warhammer. Warhammer. It's got Reaper from Overwatch on the front, so I have to. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes! This is the power that I have missed! I am Thor! Fear me! That's how Thor sounds, right? Oh, my God, I'm fucking amazing with these. Back. maybe it can't send stuff to each other fast enough, and there is going to be a lot of lag. Zero lag whatsoever. I did notice some stuff when I was in there. I don't know if it showed up in the video, but sometimes it seems like the resolution changed, or it seems like some artifacting came up, or some coloring came up. I don't know if that's something being sent to the Vive, and then it's not picking it up probably, like it's not getting a full HDMI signal, and then it auto-adjusts the resolution or whatever. No idea. I don't know how that works. It's always going to be different on the screen than what, or on this compared to what you guys see. So I don't know if that's going to show up at all. And then sometimes, that might have just been a game thing where I hit things too many times, and then the game kind of all slowed down, but I don't know if the processing slowed down. No idea. I am immensely impressed by this. This is fucking crazy. This is legitimately a game changer. And I don't say that often, because normally it's like, the audio strap is like, well, the Oculus Rift did that. And the controllers, if you upgraded the controllers, I'm like, well, this is just controllers. Wireless VR is insane. Some of you might have tried it out already because you got like Google Cardboard or something, you had it on your face with your phone. And that's wireless, because then you can just move around all you want. That's incredible even on its own. But to have high-end VR, like actual professional VR that costs a lot of money and is kind of pushing the boundaries for what like frame rates and resolutions can do, this is nuts. I can't believe it works as well as I like hoped it would. This is exactly what I wanted. Still some stuff I need to figure out, like the pack. I turned around too quickly at one point and it fell out, but that maybe because I'm wearing flamingo shorts, baby! And they just fell out of the pocket like that, so maybe I'll just wear pants that have zip-up pockets, or maybe I'll get a fanny pack just for this and just have it on my back, because then I can put my pack for my lav mic in there as well. But I'm really excited! I cannot wait! And some people said, well, can't you just go anywhere in VR then? But the thing with these base stations, the sensors that detect the headset, you have to have them a max of 16 feet apart. I think that's what it was when I got them and set them up, so I don't know if it's still like that. But so you can't go that far, but this basically blows the lid on what size room I can have now. Because before it was like, okay, so not only is the size of the room going to determine these things, but it was also the cable coming out of that was going to determine where I could go, but don't need to worry about that anymore. Absolutely crazy. And with the deluxe audio strap, with the actual headphones built onto the headset, oh my god, I cannot wait. I cannot wait to do more HTC Vive stuff now that I have some new toys to try it out with. So isn't it nuts to just see it floating without anything else? Oh man, anyway.